Yeah, I decided to make it part three. Because I want to talk about this dieting that I'm on, this 60-day juicing dieting that I'm going to do it my way. And I believe by doing it the way I'm doing it, it's going to be much better for everyone that would like to try my dieting formula. And I believe that what I'm doing is much better and that anyone will be able to do it. Because I believe first thing in the juicing is to realize that this is something that you're going to do, that it's important for everyone that's around you to give you all the support that they can do. It is important that you do have the support of your family. And there's nothing like letting people know in advance that you're going to be taking on this very important mission that is about getting better as far as healthier, so that you can feel better. And by feeling better, you're going to start doing things that's gonna make you even feel much better. So it's just nothing but a step in the right direction that's gonna help you and everybody around you. Because if they love you, then they're gonna help you no matter what you decide and how you decide to do it. That's what family is all about. Helping one another get through these difficult times. And that's what it is. It's a difficult time because you have to decide that this is what you're going to do. And then you're going to have to prepare for this because you're going to have all the things, all the tools that you need for this to even start. So that's why I said it's going to take time, because you need to get your money together as far as blenders, juicers. Get those first. And you can find some good deals on them, so there ain't no excuse. And then you're going to have to realize that the most important is the fruits and the vegetables. And you're gonna have to know exactly where to get those at. Those are very high. So I'll tell you one thing, if you really want to get the fruits and vegetables, it's Meijer's. They have the best. They have plenty of everything, and you can buy them like you need to buy them. So my advice to you, go to Meijer and get your fruits and vegetables. Kroger's have some good deals on berries and stuff from time to time. So I would check both of them out. So them are the two. And Farmer's Market, of course. And then you can find people that's on the roadside, you know, sets up tents and stuff. They have good stuff. I try to find stuff that's organic, stuff that's not, don't have no pesticides on them. So everything I do, man, I know that I'm trying to do is get away from chemicals, period. I don't want no kind of chemicals in my body. I know I ain't gonna be able to get rid of all of it, but I'm gonna do my best. And even though the food is a little expensive, as far as organic versus non-organic, and you can't afford organic, you should buy what you can afford and just wash them off. Shit, wash it off pretty good. That's what I do. Can't afford that shit all the time. I mean, because the juicing is important. You damn near have to have juice like 2 or 3 times a day. But I find out that the best way to do it is basically, if you're going to do this thing, be wise about it and think about your body and your mind and know that no matter what going on around you, you're going to stick to this diet because you know what? You're going to be able to see what's going on next year and the year after next. You don't want to be getting all caught up in the moment with food and stuff, and then you fall off. And then what's going to happen is you're going to really regret that. You're going to be hating yourself just because you did this. So here you are, you got this diet guy problem with all these other diseases. Now you feel like you failed because you didn't. It didn't go as according as you planned, but that's okay. That's okay. I mean, don't even worry about that. You just keep going. That's what makes you stronger. You don't worry about that. You keep going. First of all, you say, yeah, I made a mistake. I know I was wrong. I was tempted, but it was just overwhelming, and that's all right. Just as long as you know that you made a mistake and that you say to yourself that, yeah, okay, but it's going to make you stronger. Not to say you go ahead and do it and make that mistake again. But I wouldn't worry about it, man. You know, there's nothing ever going to happen just like we all plan on happening. Just like the other day, you know. My sister had some dressing, some macaroni cheese, and some yam. That wasn't so bad. Have my wife go get me some, put it in the fridge for a couple of days. I said, I've been on the fasting juice diet for 22 days. Didn't eat nothing. But at the same time, I was strong about it, but I felt that this is when things changed for me, this 22-day thing. So I know that you can juice up to 22 days and you get this feeling once you're doing good. And I feel from that 22 days, you can't start eating food, but not real food, not food like, you know, meat. But what I did, when I told her to be honest, I ate that chicken, that dressing, and most of them know I don't fucking eat meat while I'm on this fasting. Just snuck it in on me, but that's cool. It wasn't that much. You know, they could have made a mistake, but to have some macaroni cheese and some yam, wanted some of them greens, but they had put them ham hocks in the greens, and they know I don't eat none of that pork shit. So that's cool, but it was so good. And even though I felt that I was kind of cheating myself, I realized that I didn't intentionally do this as far as, you know, eating meat, you know. But I felt that there wasn't nothing really wrong with it at the time. That it was over with. It was a mistake. And I really didn't feel bad about it because I had done 22 days straight. I never, ever even tried this type of long period. Anyway, so I felt okay. I felt all right because I knew I was strong. My mind was strong. And I knew that even though I did eat this, it didn't really bother me because my mind was strong enough because I felt that those 22 days was great and that I could do it again. And it's not going to deter me because I ate a piece of meat that was in some damn dressing. I'm not going to let that shit bother me, man. And so there it is. Which gave me another idea that Yahweh put on me, and that is, even though you're juicing, after a certain amount of times getting the chemicals and stuff out of your body, I believe that you can go ahead and eat. I feel that you can eat, and I'm talking about plant food. You know, they have hot dogs made out of plants. They taste like real hot dog. You put all the goodies and all the toppings on it, like I like all my peppers and all of that. And they got hamburgers the same way, just as good. Just you had to find which hamburger is good for you. I choose not to have no hamburger with no soy in it whatsoever. And that's what I'm trying to do. I also get away from meat, off from eggs and soy. No sugar, no flour, no white flours, nothing white. It's all part of the diet. Nothing. And I feel that I'm doing okay. And I'm understanding a lot more than I did in the beginning. Because I'm going through this. So I don't give a damn what nobody say about how they do stuff. I'm telling you now, we're going to go straight ghetto with them. And the stuff that they're doing, I believe that they're doing it looks all right, because I believe they're trying to put pressure on our people to think that, you know, all you have to do is just juice for your diet to even work. And that's bullshit. That's bullshit. But the thing about it is you just can't fucking be juicing and then go back to eating meat. All of this junk food. This stuff with all these chemicals on there. This is the whole purpose of dieting, is to get the chemicals out of your body. Now, if you want to eat, fine. But what can you eat to not gain weight when you're trying to eat to lose weight? You're trying to lose weight, but you don't want to try to lose weight and then eating food that don't put the weight back on you that you already lost. So I think the best thing to do is to figure out what vegan meat there is available. There are all kinds of vegan meat. You know, they got vegan hamburger, sausages. And I don't eat no pork, but it's just vegan sausage. They got vegan ham. They even got vegan cheese. Everything vegan. So this is where your money come in at. Stocking up, preparing for this stuff. You know, because once you get on this diet, you know, once you start feeling that this stuff is starting to work and you find yourself short, you don't want to put yourself in a position where you have to convert back to eating meat again, because you can complete a 30-day dieting. And I'm saying, I was just trying in the beginning to do a lot of more preparation on the food and fruits that you need, and I think you'll be all right. I see I'm out of time now, so I don't want to run over. I just wanted to say that and watch me. We're going to go through this thing together, and I'm going to be straight up with you. I'm going to show you exactly what I'm going to do. So I'll talk to you later. God is one.